Okay. Well, patients are often surprised that the antibiotics that we use are really not used as antibiotics, and that acne is not an infection. You can't pass on acne from one person to another. So, yes, the antibiotics that we use may indeed suppress, and they do reduce the bacteria called P. acnes. It doesn't seem to be the main part of how they work. The antibiotics that we use are also anti-inflammatory. They reduce the ability of white cells to get into the skin. They reduce the inflammatory part of acne. So it's important to know that they work in the twofold, in two ways. They're anti-inflammatory and maybe somewhat of the antibacterial, and that they act slowly. The response to these is not as if you had a sore throat with strep and you take an antibiotic for a week, you kill off the bugs and that's it. In acne, they work very slowly, such as you expect maybe a 50% improvement in the number of inflammatory spots that you have, less pimples, less pustules, 50% over 12 weeks, which is very slow. The philosophy, I think, has changed. I mean, 20 years ago, individuals were put on an antibiotic such as tetracycline and left on it for a very, very long time. Now that we're living in a world of antibiotic resistance, there's this awareness that maybe it's not such a smart thing to use these antibiotics for a very long time. And there's concern about antibiotic resistance, not just to bacteria in the skin, but perhaps bacteria in the gut and transferring resistance to other organisms. So I think at least the approach of many, including myself, is to use the oral antibiotics for as short a time as possible to try and reduce the amount of inflammation, get improvement in the acne as quickly as you can, because it helps compliance, because it, even if it responds quickly, it's a long time. So we use the antibiotics for maybe 2-3 months, and then hoping that the topical medications that we have can keep the acne down after the initial injection of the anti-inflammatory by mouth. So that's been sort of an evolution in the way that we think about these antibiotics. It does appear that if you add a topical benzoyl peroxide, say a benzoyl peroxide wash onto the skin when you're on an oral antibiotic, it may reduce the selection of resistant organisms. Whenever you use an antibiotic or any drug for a long time, you always have to balance the advantages to the side effects. And various antibiotics have different types of side effects, different things that we have to consider when prescribing them, and it's our responsibility to keep the patient safe. So antibiotics useful, yes. If there were better treatments, we'd use them.